Hello everybody, my name's William G and I'm just doing a tutorial on Duke Nukem's weapons in the game Demon Throne. This level is basically a zoo. We built this level to test all of the enemies and all of the effects, so this is not an official level, but it's very handy for me to show you the weapons and what they do. So I'll begin with the angle grinder. If you have ammunition for the angle grinder, it's going to lock onto an enemy and then pull you straight into the enemy and then deal extra damage. So I'll get some of these guys out. Now as you can see, it's got a red circle. It's not going to do that, it's not going to lock on, and it's not going to do much damage, or do very little damage at all. So the next weapon is the shotgun. Obviously normal shot, it's just and then alt fire, it's iron sight, and it's very accurate. It shoots one pellet, and that one pellet can headshot enemies. The headshot deals extra damage to every enemy, as long as you get the headshot. And some of these guys you'll be able to take the heads right off. The headshot extra damage counts for any enemy. Pretty much all of them have heads, so if you hit any of the heads, they will deal extra damage to the enemy. And not all of them lose their heads, but they will receive extra damage. Okay, next weapon is double barrel shotgun. Primary fire shoots one barrel, secondary fire shoots two barrels. There's been an argument against that, should be the other way around, but currently that is the way it is, so. Let's try some two barrels. Chain gun's primary fire takes a couple of seconds to warm up. And then the secondary fire is a grenade launcher. The advantage is you can use both of these at the same time, so you can use the minigun and the grenade launcher together. And that way you'll be able to take out some of the more stronger enemies in the game. will go on to RPG. Primary fire is obviously one shot. It's a fast moving missile. But more importantly, the secondary fire, with the secondary fire, if you hold it, you can load up to 5 rockets. So if you look at the right at the screen, it's loaded 5 rockets, and they will lock onto any number, well, obviously 5 enemies that are in your view. The plasma shield will deflect any projectiles from the shield. I will fire back at the enemy that's shooting them, if you can aim them. Shoots 3 bolts, and they are all homing missiles, so they will lock onto the target between 1 and 3 targets. The primary fire on the sentry while you're holding it will shoot a laser or a lightning bolt at an enemy. Ability is if you use the primary fire on a wall, you can stick these onto walls as traps, as laser traps, like in Duke Nukem, and they will shoot lightning beams at anybody who walks into the line of sight. The other ability is You can always pick these up and reuse them. If you walk up and press interact or use, then it will go back into your armory and you can use them again. They've done their job, and you can still see that they are on the wall, then you'll be able to walk up to them, press interact or use, interact or open, and it will go back into your armory and you'll have another one stock to use again. These weapons don't have an alt fire, they just have several uses for the primary fire. Very handy weapon. So next we'll go, what have we done? 4, 5, 6. Okay, cluster bombs. The primary fire shoots a short distance and then the secondary fire shoots a longer distance. With the primary fire, you have control over when the cluster bomb will go off, when it's detonated. The secondary fire will shoot quite far away and it will self-detonate. So you can actually use quite a few at once. I think that's the advantage. You can just that's the advantage of the secondary fire, is that you can use lots and lots quite fast and at a quite a long distance, but you have no control over when they detonate. Dual pistols. What makes dual pistols special is that they make enemies bleed. So they're quite handy if you get an enemy to take damage earlier on in the fight, and then over time they will die. See, they bled for quite a while and then they just died. That way I can save ammo. It's quite handy at the start of a boss battle. Next time we've got DFG. So just like in Doom, the primary fire will damage any enemy that you can see in your screen. The secondary fire is a BFG laser beam. Deals a lot of damage to whatever target you're shooting at. Thank you. this weapon has the all fire switches between fire and ice, freezing and burning. The burning ray will cause the enemy to burn over time, not just when you're shooting it, which is very handy. That's a wrap. The other thing to mention is the Kako demons go invisible. One of the abilities that you have, if you have spirit vision, is you can shoot the Kako demons while they are invisible. Night vision or spirit vision, once again, with spirit vision you can kill these ghosts. These ghosts will possess enemies in the game, and after they've possessed the enemy, that enemy will have double the amount of strength, and I think will do extra damage. If you use spirit vision while the enemy is possessed by the ghost, then you will do double damage to the enemy. that's a wrap. Thank you very much for your time. Hopefully you learned something. Bye.